Cause I'm about that.
Foolish, try to get them buns up, killing the mics just like I ran the jewels in. Y'all gonna get turned up crying on that kid with an attitude, but you can't really blame this motherfucker, he's doing what he had to do. I'm about that cash flipping, I'm getting it on and off the market. Not about that VIP, not me, not never been a fan of carpets. All about that RIP for all of my Jesus gone departed. All about that finish, what I started, I'm about that.
Top down, like you're not ready.
Fucking rapping, uterine water problem. Made a little cash in the back end, but still rapping, call me starving. Yeah, y'all gotta ask who the man is. Hope I'm gonna be like, make it parted. I'm about them two cities with me, rapping them hardest. Gotta keep it two cities.
Welcome back to New Seas. September has begun. Summer is over, and autumn is here. And the autumn star, GDY, is here too. I think my autumn shirt looks good on me. What the
What the?
Do you know a body type with a Latissimus dorsi muscle is shorter than normal? A person whose Latissimus dorsi is shorter than the normal length may experience a forward tilt of the pelvis and increased lordosis of the lumbar spine. It can cause pain in the pelvis, hips, and the back. Also, a short Latissimus dorsi muscle can cause round shoulders or imbalance of the shoulder joint. It can cause a pain and movement disorder in the shoulder joint. How can we make a body type imbalance using short latissimus dorsi muscle? Let's start now. First, let's draw. The latissimus dorsi muscle is attached to the many things. It attaches to the inferior angle of the scapular bone and to the 9th to 12th ribs. It attaches to the 7th to 12th spinous process of the thoracic spine. In the area of lumbar, it connects to the thoracolumbar fascia. The thoracolumbar fascia is attached to the 1st to 5th spinous process of the lumbar spine and the sacrum. And it is attached to the posterior 1/3 part of the iliac crest. Then it goes through the chest side and it is attached to the lesser tubercle of the humerus bone. First, if the person has a short latissimus dorsi muscle, will his shoulder height be higher or lower than a neutral height? When your spine and pelvis are fixed and the latissimus dorsi muscle is shorter, will the scapular and humerus bones go up or down? The latissimus dorsi muscle goes to downward and inward from the lesser tubercle of the humerus bone. If there is concentric activation or shortening of the latissimus dorsi muscle, the scapular and humerus bone are pulled down. So the depressed shoulder's latissimus dorsi muscle is also shorter than normal.
Cause I'm about dead!
Second, if a person has a short latissimus dorsi muscle, will his humerus bone rotate inward or outward? The latissimus dorsi muscle goes into the inner part of the humerus bone through the chest side, and it attaches to the lesser tubercle of the humerus bone. If the latissimus dorsi muscle is shorter, the humerus bone will be pulled inward. A body type with an internal rotation of the shoulder joint will have a short latissimus dorsi muscle length. If the short latissimus dorsi muscle has rotated your humerus bone internally, will your humerus bone be difficult to rotate inward or outward? You may complain of pain or movement limitation in your shoulder area when you rotate your humerus bone externally. Third, will a shortened latissimus dorsi muscle pull the humerus bone forward or backward? The latissimus dorsi muscle goes behind the back from the lesser tubercle of the humerus bone. The short latissimus dorsi muscle pulls the humerus bone backward. Your shoulder joint is an extension. Your shoulder joint becomes an extended posture. If the short latissimus dorsi muscle is pulling your humerus bone backward, will your humerus bone be difficult to move forward or back? Your humerus bone should be difficult to move forward. Your shoulder joint will feel pain and movement limitation when your shoulder flexes forward. Also, you have to consider the compensation movement of the trunk. You need to perform a gait evaluation. When performing a gait evaluation of your client, if the latissimus dorsi muscle is shoulder or hyperactive, your client will shake his arm back too much. Fourth, will the short latissimus dorsi muscle tilt pelvis bone forward or backward? And will the lumbar lordotic curve increase or decrease? The latissimus dorsi muscle is attached behind the pelvis and lower back. The short latissimus dorsi muscle can pull the pelvis posterior upward. Your pelvis will tilt forward and the lordosis of your lumbar will increase. If the short latissimus dorsi muscle made the pelvis tilted anterior direction and increase the lordosis of the lumbar spine, you should find it difficult to move your pelvis backward. Furthermore, your lumbar spine will have limitation of movement when you flex forward.
Cause I'm about dead!
The increased forward curve of your lumbar spine gets compression stress and the posterior part of your lumbar spine. Your back has folded. Try to stand with folded back for a long time. You may feel compression pain on your back after a few minutes. The nerve canal between the spines becomes narrower. There may be pressure on your nerve, causing you to feel discomfort and numbness. I have been treating a female patient for the past 10 years. Her pelvis had tilted forward and she had severe cramps during her period. Her problem completely disappeared when I corrected her pelvis and body type imbalances. Fifth, if a person has shortened latissimus dorsi muscle, will his pelvis height be higher or lower than normal? The short latissimus dorsi muscle pulls the pelvis up. It can never pull downward. Your pelvis height will be higher.
Cause I'm about dead!
Try to assess the right and left height of your client's pelvis. Imagine if the right side of your client's pelvis was higher than the left side. Which one is shorter, his right or left latissimus dorsi muscle? Of course, the right latissimus dorsi muscle, which is relatively higher than the left side, has been shortened. Habitual hyperactivity of the latissimus dorsi muscle can be observed when exercising. For example, observe the hip joint of your client when doing hip abduction exercise. Look at this handsome guy, whose right pelvis is higher than the left. His right pelvis more elevated by his right latissimus dorsi muscle than overused than left side. This is also checking the one leg standing test. This handsome guy is uplifting his right pelvis when his right leg up. There is not uplifting in the left leg. Let's summarize body types in which the latissimus dorsi muscle is shorter than the normal length. First, a body type in which the shoulder height is lower rather than neutral. Second, a body type in which the shoulder joint is internally rotated rather than neutral. Third, a body type in which the shoulder joint is extended backward rather than neutral. Fourth, a body type in which the pelvis bone is anteriorly tilted rather than neutral. Fifth, a body type in which one side of the pelvic bone higher rather than the other side. Let's summarize body types in which the latissimus dorsi muscle is longer than normal length. It's easy to think the other way. First, a body type in which the shoulder height is higher rather than neutral. Second, a body type in which the shoulder joint is externally rotated rather than neutral. Third, a body type in which the shoulder joint is flexed forward rather than neutral. Fourth, a body type in which the pelvis bone is posteriorly tilted rather than neutral. Fifth, a body type one side of the pelvic bone is lower than the other side. If your client's latissimus dorsi muscle is shorter than normal, you should help them to stretch and relax it. Keep the normal length. If your client latissimus dorsi muscle is shorter than normal, you should shorten its overstretched length, naturally shortened until it reaches the normal length. Accomplishing this is straightforward. I'll discuss it in the next episode. Body type anatomy quiz. Choose the two body parts which are shorter than the normal length in this picture. First, lower shoulder. Second, higher shoulder. Third, higher pelvic. Fourth, lower pelvic.
Cause I'm about dead!
Do not just sit there and watch, act on it. Don't just look at it, make it yours. You can do it. First, draw the latissimus dorsi muscle. Assess your own body type. So think about it, is the length of my latissimus dorsi muscle normal or abnormal? You can tear it off, the latissimus dorsi muscle. The body type anatomy bent. Please upload your pictures of latissimus dorsi muscle or a sensational tearing actions on Instagram. Also, you should include the hashtag #BodyTypeAnatomy and tag @GDYBodyFirst. I'll be checking your pictures and videos, and I'll send you a present. I hope today's video will help you to be a genius of body types. See you soon, guys. You can do it.
Cause I'm about dead. Cause I'm about